Hi, beautiful souls. Welcome to You Are Art. It's so good to be here with you. Yes. You already know. It's always a pleasure to be here. You know, it's been a minute. We back on and popping. That's always going to be the case. I ain't going nowhere. We're not going anywhere, okay? Period. I hope everybody's well wherever you're at. If you're new to my channel, definitely like, subscribe. Okay, we're only going to be giving positive content, positive quality, okay? So what I want to talk today about is a journey of mine called Believe in Your Soul. This is an ongoing journey, right? We all have a journey of believing in our soul. So this is a book I just launched, and it took me 10 years to write this book. And did y'all know there are only 5% of authors that are Black? Unbelievable. That status came out this year in 23. 5%. So support all the Black authors you can. If you're an aspiring author, I'm here to encourage you. You can do it. Okay, if I could do it, y'all could do it, if that's what you want. What is believing in your soul? So believing in your soul is believing in the deeper part of yourself, deeper than ego. Sometimes we identify ourselves with ego and we think, oh, I'm Jamaican. Oh, I'm a doctor. Oh, I'm a teacher. Yada, yada, yada. That's not who you are. Okay, believing in your soul is believing in your higher self, the capital S, kind of like id in psychology. So yeah, that's what believing in your soul is. It's believing in the deeper part, the part that is immortal, the part of you that is energy that can never be destroyed, like science says. Okay, that part of you never dies. Even when your body dies, your soul still lives on. Okay, it's that part is immortal. So that is why I titled the book To Believe in Your Soul. Well, I actually like that, To Believe in Your Soul. But you know, the title is that for that reason, okay? To believe in something deeper than limiting beliefs that we may have about ourselves. You know, I do mention a lot about the Bible in there, not to be biblical, because I'm not biblical. I'm not super religious at all. But even like in Genesis, when they talk about God and that we as humans are made out of the likeness of God, we all have that God essence, God energy, God presence within us, okay? So that is why I put quotes here and there from the Bible, but I also use other holy sects, like quotes from the Quran, quotes from the Bhagavad Gita, okay? Because it's like, I don't believe in just one religion. It's like, oh, end all be all, or oh, Jesus is the only way. That is how colonizers came here to control us, okay? I'm gonna just be real. So that's why I put different pieces of positive energy from various sects around the world. I also, throughout the book, so it's very unconventional, y'all. Okay, yes, it's self-help, it's self-transformational. However, it's very unconventional in that, you know, I do have, it's kind of like a bunch of different things. So you got the quotes from the different holy sects, you got a little bit about my story woven in and out throughout. Okay, I do mention my son Camden, and he's actually channeled throughout the book. So given that I'm a medium, I channel him throughout the book in various parts. So it's not like any other book you've read. Every chapter has positive affirmations, practices that you can do, and so forth. I also include quotes and sayings that I learned from people along the way, because we never know why we're listening to somebody say something. And that could be God's source energy moving through that person in that moment to tell you what you need to hear. They're using that vessel as a message for you. So there have been times in my life where I never forgot some of these messages, and I put them in the book because I know if it helped me out, it might help you out. Okay? Okay, so when it comes to my favorite line in the book, this is tied to like the affirmations and the practices at the end of every chapter. There's one mantra that I have where I say, may everything I think, say, do, and feel be in perfect alignment with my higher self for my highest good and for the highest good of all. I love that mantra. I try to say it every day when I can remember, y'all. Okay, I'm human. But it's just my favorite line in the book because to me, it just doesn't get better than that. But other people might differ and have another favorite. What inspired me to write this book is life can be hard. Okay, life be lifin'. Let's keep it a buck. So So because I know how much life has lived within my life, I was like, you know what? If I've had this hard of a time, I'm sure somebody else can benefit from some of the things I learned along the way. Because I feel like we can learn from everybody along the way. I don't care if you're 4 years old. I can learn something from you. Okay? And, you know, my journey has been impactful, so it's like, might as well pay it forward. I done been through a lot. I done been through hell and back and some. And I'm standing. I'm standing strong and tall. So for me, that's something that's always inspired me. It's been the fire within me that allowed myself to keep pushing forward. And I know, like, I've had days where I couldn't get up. I couldn't get out of bed. Not because I was, you know, unhealthy or I had some ailment, an issue with mobility, but because depression had came over me, okay? It's real. It can be real. So that is what inspired me. You know, I think about folks who are in pain, who are suffering spirits. You know, on the outside, you might think everything's okay, but you don't know that person's story. You don't know what they're going through. You don't know what they need to get through the day, to have a better day, to wake up tomorrow. There's people that want to take their lives. You know what I'm saying? So that's what inspired me to write this book and to never give up, considering it took me 10 years because life happened. Yeah. What can people gain out of this? I would say what I just mentioned before, for sure, encouragement, inspiration. You know, this is self-help. This is about you helping yourself. I can't do it for you. They can gain self-transformation, so transforming self. They can gain, you know, I'm hoping people can gain something positive out of it. As long as you gain something positive about it, that really makes me feel like the mission has been fulfilled, the purpose has been served. You know, considering that at the end of every chapter, there's these affirmations, you know, that's something people can gain, you know, learning how to tell yourself positive affirmations in the mirror every day before you leave the house, you know, gassing yourself up, boosting yourself up, because that's going to happen from the inside out. You're going to start to believe even if you don't believe. And that's why it's called Believe. You know, it's not because you already believe in it. I wrote it. It's because I know what it's like to not believe. I know what it's like to have struggled with self-esteem, self-worth, not believing that you're worthy. And the fact that we are all existing proves in itself that you are worthy. We are all worthy. So I feel like that's what people can gain out of this. I put little prompts off, okay? Don't mind me. okay. I already told you guys why it's unconventional. Also, I will say that I do have the Haitian Loa. Christians, don't come for me, y'all. Do not come for me, Christians, okay? Y'all Bible beaten. Be the first to judge sometimes. And it's like, God is love, okay? I'm gonna put that out there. God is love. But the cover of my book does have a veve, which is a symbol that the Tainos and the Haitians used to work together to bring in these Haitian spirits, Loa, aka Law, into ceremonies. So I do have the veve, a symbol of a Haitian Loa, on the cover of the book. Erzuli Freda, beautiful story she has. I will do a video on her soon, possibly the next video I do. So yeah, that's one reason why it's unconventional. And then I got Bible verses and I got cuss words at the same damn time. Okay. And it's not that like I'm a big potty mouth. I actually try not to curse so much. But I love in that book, Conversations with God, where he states that, you know, who cares? God doesn't care if you say the F word, it's just a word. So there's a couple F-bombs. So it is a PG-13 plus, okay, book. But that in itself is very unconventional. I've had people already unfollow me because they were Bible-beating Christians and they saw that the cover had this Haitian Loa's veve, or Zélie Freda's veve, her symbol. And it's like, why are you judging me? You know, this is not devil worshiping. I talk a lot about God in the book because I needed God. I need God always. And I put God first. And that's something people don't know about Voodooism, is that Voodooism always put God first, okay? They believe God comes first and then comes the Loa after God. Next is, it's okay, yeah. So what this book is about, the essence of it is about believing. It's about living your life, rewriting your story, okay? It doesn't matter what you came from. Not to say it doesn't matter, because that's what made you, but it's about how you want the end chapters of your life to be. How do you want to write the rest of your chapters out to be like? Okay, So it's about dreaming your dreams, going after what you want to do. It doesn't matter if you want to be a janitor. It doesn't matter if you want to be the world's best basketball star. It doesn't matter if you want to be a firefighter or whatever you want to do, you know, but just believing in that and going for that is what this book is about. It's about transformation, allowing yourself to have a rebirth, okay? And not being stagnant, not being stuck in the past or a victim to your circumstances. It's about being a victor and not a victim, okay? And lastly, where you can find this copy of the book, Believe in Your Soul, is two places right now. One is on my website, www.soulexo.online. And this is where you do support the author more by buying it directly on the website, okay, because it's my website. Or you can also purchase it on Amazon. So globally, all over the world, if you got Prime, it takes 2 days to arrive. Give it as a gift. It's about to be the holiday season, y'all. Please support Black authors. I'm gonna say it again, support Black authors. There's only 5% of us. We need more support, okay? We need more support. So definitely check out Believe in Your Soul. Also check out my podcast called Believe in Your Soul, available everywhere, Spotify, Pandora, all of that, okay? I thank you so much. Those of you who don't know, I do offer readings. I'm a healer, speaker. I offer tarot readings and mediumship, and I'm always available for speaking engagements, okay? Thank you for listening, y'all. Peace and love. Remember, you are art.